Hi, this is Brad with Copper Creek Cuts, a lawn care company in Northeast Florida, here with the Chevy 2500 truck reveal. Make sure and check the chapters if you want to skip around, find something specific. First thing we'll cover is why a 2500? Why did I completely skip upgrading to a 1500? I had a Chevy Colorado. The short answer is I didn't want to outgrow another vehicle. Chevy Colorado, the max tow for that one was 3500. 1500s with a V8 with the max tow package, I would be able to tow 9,600 pounds for like $35,000 or $36,000 with some of the quotes that I got. For another $10,000, you can bump that number up to 14,500 towing. So a pretty significant increase. The capability here is much more bang for your buck when you're looking at towing. The second thing that we'll cover is why did I have one built? Because I didn't buy this off the lot. I actually had it built and ordered. And the short answer to that is because there are no dealers who are stocking 2500s that are not four-wheel drive. Almost all of them are four-wheel drive, and we just simply don't need that. We live in Florida. I'm not going to be in mud. I'm not going to be on construction sites. I'm not driving in snow. I don't need four-wheel drive, and that added $2,000 or $3,000, depending on, you know, whatever package they had. When you added on everything that we wanted, it's got to be black. It's got to be at least the custom trim level. It's got to be crew cab. It's got to have the long bed, not the standard bed. The available pool just kept shrinking until eventually when you added the two-wheel drive, there were none available. There weren't any that dealers had. Now the process of building. How does building a truck or a vehicle actually work? First, pick a dealer. I emailed about 30 of them and said, hey, this is the build of the truck I want. What's your lowest out the door? Only a handful were willing to actually give me a quote sheet. A large majority were just like, hey, if you want to buy it with us, you can. We won't really know what the price is until it comes in. There were some others who were a little bit more helpful and were like, we really won't know what the price is. Here's all the fees that would be added on to it whenever it comes in. Let us know if you want to move forward. And then there were about two that gave me an actual quote and said, we won't know for sure. This is the closest we can get. The reason they don't know for sure is because when they run pricing, they have to pull the invoice of the vehicle. And if the vehicle is not built, there is no invoice. So they're kind of just doing a ballpark rough estimate. We had to put down a $2,000 deposit. They submitted the order to GM. From there, we were quoted 2 weeks to know if GM accepted it or not. Somebody who put in an order for a 2500 2 days after me had theirs declined. The specific things they built, GM said, no, we just can't do it. Maybe they were on short supply, some of the package trim options, you know, whatever they added on. So 2 weeks went by, I called for an update, and then 2 days after that, they got back in touch with me, the dealer, and said GM approved the order. From there, we were looking at an 8 to 12 week build process. A little less than a month later, I got a call, so I put down the deposit on the 8th. On February the 25th, I found out GM had accepted the offer. March the 23rd, just under 4 weeks later, we got a call that the truck was built, it was done, so that 8 to 12 weeks only came out to 4 week build time. Now we were in a 2 week transportation window. So they quoted me April 6th is the delivery date plus or minus 5 days. So the way that it works is once it's built, it's loaded onto rail cars. Once those rail cars are full enough to make a trip worthwhile, they get shipped from wherever to wherever, and then it gets transported to my dealer on the back of a tractor trailer. The only hiccup I had in the build process from March the 24th till about April 7th, there were 2 weeks where I did like 4 or 5 emails, 7 calls. I couldn't get anybody to call me back to let me know how much this truck was actually going to cost. Now that it's built, we've got an invoice. I'd like to see how much it's going to cost. I need the VIN number so I can get insurance on it. I want to know what the supplier pricing ended up being. My wife works for Florida Blue, so she gets supplier pricing. Nobody was giving me a call back. Finally, I talked to a manager, you know, somebody higher up, and the next day I got a call back. It was also the next day that the truck was going to be delivered. So it was kind of annoying, but it didn't ultimately change anything. So then we went and picked the truck up and I dropped off a check for the remaining balance. There was no financial incentive to finance it, meaning that there were no banks that they had a relationship where we could have got more knocked off of the price if we financed with them. And if, you know, if you're going to finance with somebody and get $1,000 off, I'm fine doing that and paying an early loan termination fee if there is one, if it makes financial sense. That wasn't the case, so we just went ahead and wrote a check for the difference. So there is no car payment on this. We own this outright. Very fortunate. Big thanks to YouTube and the success we've had there to be able to save up enough to do something like this. As it was built, it was $45,175. I'll go over the build after this. Supplier pricing knocked that down to $43,63. There was a $39 electronic filing registration fee for Florida, $650 tire and battery fee, which brought the total price of the car to $43,108.50. Sales tax added $2,634.17. Another DMV fee for the transfer of a tag from $165.85. The cash balance due was $45,908.52 minus a $1,250 rebate. When I built the truck in February, the rebate was $1,750. Unfortunately, in April when I picked it up, it had gotten knocked down to $1,250. I'd already put down a $2,000 deposit. The $1,250 rebate meant that when I picked up the truck, I wrote a check for $42,658.52. In total, the truck cost $44,658.52. Not an insignificant amount of money, but I am happy with the purchase. I feel like it was the most fair deal that I could have gotten, considering the fact that I shopped 30 dealers. Most of them were not very helpful, and the one that I went with did not have any dealer fees. All the others, $650, $900, $700 dealer fees that they would have added on to this price. Relatively speaking, I think we got the best deal that we could have. It is a two-wheel drive, 2500, crew cab, long bed, custom trim. That's the base level of it. The only packages we added were the custom convenience package and the safety confidence package. The custom convenience package, the main reason I got that one was the integrated brake controller. The safety confidence package added cruise control. One of those added cruise control and I had to have that. The Chevy Colorado did not have cruise control, and that's something you learn you really need if you're ever gonna do time on the highway. I was just trying to get the Colorado as cheap as I could, but cruise control you have to have. As far as options, for $55, I added the roof lamp markers. For $35, I got some wiring provisions for fifth wheel or gooseneck, which it's not set up for fifth wheel or gooseneck. I don't think I'll ever tow that way. And then a cloth rear seat with storage package option, which makes a drop down armrest. There's storage in the seat backs. And when you flip the seats up, there's now a little storage area with a lip that you can store things. I added these running boards. These running boards were only, I think they were under $200 off of Amazon. Of course, the dealer wants like $600 for them. Cover King neoprene car seat covers. I had these in the Colorado. I liked them a lot. They, you know, have covers for every little piece of the truck. I didn't do a great job of installing them, but we put in rear fender liners. These we had to order direct from our local dealer. They were $150 for the pair. I put them in myself. They wanted an hour's worth of labor, which is close to $100 to put them in. It took me probably 2 hours because some things didn't line up right. But if you're gonna do that, do it yourself and save some money. And then another thing we're gonna do is, we just got back from camping, so that's what the mess is. But we are going to Raptor line the bed. I should have ordered it from the factory, the bed liner, because it's ended up being cheaper than any other places we're getting quotes for. But I wouldn't change it even if I could, because that bed liner might have been something that got the order rejected. So I wouldn't have wanted to mess with that. That's the specifics on our situation, our experience with building a truck, with picking it up, the actual specific build of this truck. So if you've got any questions, do some Google searching. There's probably going to be other videos that'll answer it. I'll try and put some more info in the description. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it.